Hi, today we are going to see about what are the defects in the coating of tablets and how to overcome those defects. Before going into this topic, I want you people to know about some prerequisites which you need to keep in your mind to understand this. Okay, those prerequisites are, if I tell process related variables, it means spray rate, drying time, anything related to drying time and anything related to spray rate. Are getting smaller droplets or larger droplets, anything that these things are related in process related variables. Then formulation related, if I say formulation related variable, then you have to think that I am talking about what are the contents in the formula, and due to that content, what is the viscosity of that formula, higher viscosity, lower viscosity, everything related to formula. Next, equipment related, if I say equipment related variable, it means equipment speed or what are the conditions of the equipment, etc., related for equipment. So this prerequisite you need to keep in your mind, then we can start what are the defects in the tablet coating. So I just list out the defects. Those are blistering, cratering, pitting, blooming, blushing, orange peel, sticking and picking, color variation, logo bridging, erosion and twinning. We'll see what is blistering. Here, this is purely related to the process. Blistering occurs due to drying stress. You need to know what is drying stress. Okay, what happens, assume there is a tablet like this, you have coated this tablet with a solution. Okay, so now while drying, what happens, the solvent will try to move away. Assume I am trying to represent only small portion here. Okay, so solvent molecules try to, what do you mean by drying? You are taking out solvent from the coating solution, that is called the drying. Okay, so solvent, when it is leaving the coating solution, what happens, obviously coating solution contains some of the polymers, so we use some polymers for the coating. See, this solvent will previously that solvent is holded by the polymer. When you are drying, what happens, this solvent make the polymer to get stress like this. It will pull the polymer and it will, molecule will go away. Due to this, there will be blister forming. And also, if your drying time is very quick, you are using more heat and less time, then what happens, there is a chance that some of the solvents or air can entrap within the blister, within the coating solution, forming a blister. So here air is entrapped here, so we can clearly see the blistering there. Okay, this is called blistering, and this how it occurs. So how to avoid it, obviously use mild drying conditions. Okay, drying stress, to know what is exactly what is drying stress, take a paper, dip in the water, keep it in drying in the sunlight. Okay, what happens, you can clearly see after drying the paper will have uneven surface. Why? That is because the fiber which is present in the paper holding water, this water while drying, it will induce the stress. Okay, assume this is a fiber and this is a solvent. Okay, when the solvent is going away, it will just pull that polymer and it will go away. The shape of the polymer has been modified. This we call it as a drying stress, stress induced by the drying. Okay, so use mild conditions to avoid blistering. Then cratering. Cratering means there are some pores on the tablet surface. Okay, now what happens when you use a solvent, when you use a drying, more drying condition, okay, your drying condition is not good, then what happens, there is a chance that if you use more heat in the drying, thus whatever the polymer are there, they will get melt and they will penetrate into the pores of the tablet surface. So due to the penetrated in the pores of the tablets, there will be a structure created which look like volcanic crate. Okay, that we call it as cratering. How to avoid this? Increase the viscosity of the solution. If you increase the viscosity of the solution, what happens, that solution will not penetrate into the pores of the tablet. One, two, maintain the drying condition, process related and formulation related. If you maintain the drying condition and if you increase the viscosity of the solution, the increased viscosity of the solution, that solution will not penetrate here, it will be staying here only, it will not penetrate into the pores of the tablet. Due to this, you can avoid cratering. Then we have pitting. You can see pits on the tablets. What is the reason for the pitting? Tablet Now, whatever the formulation related reason is, whatever the ingredient you are using, this is a purely formulation related, okay? Whatever the, not purely, it is mainly formulation related and some part is related to process also. You have an ingredient which is having a melting point, let's say that ingredient melting point is 40 degrees centigrade and you are using a drying temperature that is 60 degrees centigrade. Then what happens? Obviously that ingredient will get melt and create bits on the tablet surface. So avoid formulation related, avoid using a ingredient whose melting point is lesser than the drying temperature. Avoid that. Use the ingredient whose melting point is more than the drying temperature. One. Next, maintain the drying conditions. You can avoid pitting. Next is blooming. Blooming, you can see there is uneven distribution of the color. Okay, what happens in the bloomings? If you are using a this mainly occurs due to formulation, 80% formulation and 20% like say process related. It is 80% formulation related. You are using a plasticizer whose molecular weight is less. Generally we use a plasticizer whose molecular weight is less. Now what happens while drying? This plasticizer is associated with a solvent. When you prepare a solution, okay, coating solution, that plasticizer is associated with the solvent. While drying, the solvent is getting evaporated along with the solvent. Because your plasticizer molecular weight is low, it is also travel along with the solvent while drying. But when it comes to the surface, plasticizer can't be volatile, or you can say sublimation, it can't get in the process of sublimation. So all the plasticizer will accumulate at the surface and your solvent will escape, leaving the plasticizer there. Till surface, solvent and plasticizer both are associated with each other, but when the when it comes to the surface, solvent will get evaporated but plasticizer stays there. Now due to this, what happens? Wherever you see the plasticizer, there will be dull in the color, and wherever there is no plasticizer, there will be color will be normal. So dulling of the color, we call it as blooming. So how to avoid it? Avoid using plasticizer whose molecular weight is very less, and also you maintain drying condition. In all process you have to maintain the drying conditions, okay? That is the common. Okay, avoid using a low molecular weight plasticizer. Remember, blooming is due to plasticizer. Okay, low molecular weight, any ingredient you are using which is associated with the solvent molecule. Next is blushing. You can see white specks on the tablet, blush. Okay, what do you mean? How it occurs? Reason, due to the precipitation of the polymer. You use the polymer in the coating solution, that polymer will get precipitated. There are two reasons why the polymer will get precipitated. Okay, one is high temperature. Okay, variation in the temperature, sudden variation in the temperature leads the polymer to get precipitated. And next is sorbitol. Why sorbitol? If you use sorbitol, there is a chance, it has been observed that sorbitol will increase the precipitation of the polymer. Okay, it will change its melting point or something. So sorbitol will influence the precipitation of the polymer. Due to this, polymer will get precipitated. Wherever the polymer is getting precipitated, you can see white specks there on the tablet surface. So avoid using higher temperatures or sudden variation in the temperature or sorbitol in the formula. So this is formulation related and higher temperature is process related. Next is orange peel effect. You can clearly see the coating of the solution is getting off like a orange peel. Why it is happening? One is process related, is rapid drying. If you dry rapidly, what happens? At one part it will get dried quicker, other part it will get dried slowly. Due to that, there will be an orange peel effect. And to avoid this orange peel effect, increase the viscosity or maintain the viscosity of the solution. If you increase the viscosity of the solution higher, now due to this also, because drying will be not proper, due to this your tablet will show orange peel effect. What I am saying is, if the viscosity of the spraying solution is more, it will not dry properly, it will eventually cause a orange peel effect. Okay, so maintain the proper viscosity and do not dry rapidly. Next is sticking and picking. Sticking indicates sticking of tablets together. Picking indicates solution or coating solution of the tablet which I need to be present on the surface of the tablet is been picked by the pan. Pan will pick that. Okay, that solution is going to stick to the pan. We call it as a picking. So difference between sticking and twinning. Twinning is only two tablets. Sticking, you can say 3, 4, 5 tablets stick together. So why this happens? Why they are sticking together? One, because the solution is not dried properly. So drying conditions, viscosity is more, again formulation related. Okay, so and also spray rate. Wherever I say so process related, remember spray rate and drying both are interrelated. If you spray more and use less drying time, gone. If you spray less and use more drying time, gone. So spray rate and drying time should be maintained properly together to get a proper coating. Okay, so sticking, why it occurs? 3 or 4 tablets, they didn't get dried properly, hence they will come together and stick together. So they form a group, that we call it as sticking. Picking, again same thing, even though if they don't form the group, because the drying is not proper, there is a chance that wherever, assume that drying is not proper here and drying is proper here, wherever there is no drying, there is a chance that it will go and stick to the pan, and while rotating it will come out from that pan, and whatever the solution is been coated on the tablet surface is stick to the pan, which is come out from the tablet. So we call this as a picking. Pan is picking your coated solution. This both occurs due to, purely due to drying rate and spraying rate. Okay, drying condition and spray. Next is color variant. Why color is not proper on the tablet surface after coating? Reason, improper mixing. Obviously, if you don't mix solution properly, there will be a cause of color variation. Next, migration of soluble dyes. If there are any dyes which are soluble there, okay, they will get migrate if the molecular weight is less, has happened in plasticizer. So they will migrate here and there due to the what happens, you get improper color distribution. So we get color variation. So mix properly and use proper dyes here. Next is bridging or logo bridging. What happens here? If I want to import a logo, let's say my logo is like this. If I want to import the logo, if I see this on the tablet surface, okay, if I see this is, assume this is a tablet surface, if I see this like this, clearly see 3 lines, 1, 2, 3, this one and this one, 3. Okay, I'm cutting into diagonally like this. Okay, now I want my solution to clearly coat this logo also, space represent in the logo. So this space represent this 3-1. Okay, I want my solution to go and sit into that logo space. Now the solution is not sitting there and it is covering the logo like this, hence we call it forming a bridge over the logo. We call it as logo bridging. If I'm a bridge, see, I want the solution to cover this one, instead of covering it, forming a bridge here. So we call, the term is called as logo bridging. So obviously why it occurs? Poor design of your logo to larger droplet. If the droplet is large, it will come and sit here like this. So you should atomize it finely, then only that fine droplet will go and sit into the place where logo is created. Next is spray rate. If the spray rate is less, okay, then what happens? You get more bigger droplets. So use proper spray rate. Next, increase solid content. If in your coating solution, if the solid content is more, that solid will come and sit into the space where the logo is being created and it form a bridge there. So we call it as a logo bridging. So decrease the solid content in your coating solution, and viscosity also. If the coating solution is viscous, like in the cratering, see, in cratering I want the solution to be viscous because I want it to be stay there. I don't want that solution to penetrate in the pores. Opposite to this is bridging. If the solution is viscous, it won't penetrate into the design or space created for the logo. It will stay there because it is so viscous. Solution will try to stay here only. It won't penetrate because it is viscous. Due to this, it will form a bridge there. Okay, eventually leading for logo bridging. Hence, maintain proper viscosity of your coating solution. Next is, yeah, wherever I say viscosity, it is formulation related, solid content, formulation related, spray rate, process related, okay, like that. Next is erosion. Erosion mainly occurs because While assume this is a tablet, you have coated the tablet. While coating, we want that coating solution to form like this. If the spray rate is more, okay, or if the tablet is getting over wetted, so what happens? Assume the tablet is getting wetted here. When it get wet, tablet will lengthen its integrity, its strength. Due to that, after drying, what happens? Whatever portion is there, there will be erosion like this, because it is getting over wetted. And also, if the tablet is having not good strength, okay, hardness, this also creates your erosion. So how to avoid this? Spray rate, over wetting. Why over wetting happens? Spray rate and drying process related. And if the strength of the tablet is not good, so go back to the tablet formula, that is again formulation related. Impart good strength to the tablet. Okay, next, by inducing binders. Next is twinning. Here twin means two tablets are joining together. This is purely a design problem. Design related to what tablet? Let's say I have a tablet, one tablet is like this, another tablet is like this. See the space between this. Okay, not space, see the design. There is a flat surface, okay, at the here and here we have a flat surface. So you are giving more surface area for the tablet to get stick like this. This is a tablet, one surface, another surface. Okay, if I could not dry, okay, if the tablet, these surfaces are wet, what happens? When they come close, they will form twin like this, move together, twinning. How to avoid this? Make the surface curve. If I make the curve here, design of the tablet like this, just I will prepare this type of design. Now what happens? Assume that design is like this. See here, you are getting only less surface of point of contact, less surface to the contact point. Okay, so there is no more surface area there for the point of contact. Here you have good surface area, here you have less point of contact. So by just changing the design of the tablet, you can avoid twinning. Okay, you can also avoid twinning by spray rate and pan speed. Okay, here equipment related, pan speed is there. If the speed of the pan is not proper, obviously, if that speed is good, the tablet will stay away from each other. If the speed is not good, obviously they will come close. At lower speeds of the pan, tablet will be coming close together. When the solution is not dried properly, they form twinning, or you can say sticking. More, three or more tablets came together and stick. Okay, difference between sticking and twinning is three or more tablets, twinning mainly two. Twins, when we say twins, only when two people are involved. Okay, if you increase or maintain the proper pan speed, you can avoid twinning. Or design problem, change the design of the tablet to avoid twinning. Okay, I hope you understand. Thank you.